Hi guys, this is Mark. In this video, I'd like to introduce a new feature we recently added to Backendless, which is support for JSON. And the feature is in Backendless database, in addition to all the standard column types that we had supported previously, such as strings, dates, integers, file references. Now you can store JSON values. And for this, you would create a column of type JSON and write in Backendless database, either using Backendless console or the APIs, you can store JSON values. These JSON values could be anything that JSON supports. So you could store JSON objects, arrays, literal values, strings, numbers, and so on. And once the data is stored in the database, there is a lot of things that you can do with it. So for instance, the whole querying language with the where clause that we support, we have expanded it with a bunch of different functions that allow you to retrieve data from the database based on the actual values that exist in your JSON documents. So for instance, you could reference a specific path within the JSON document and create a condition. And if that condition is true, then the entire object that contains this JSON will be returned back to your client application. All our SDKs have been updated. There is a lot of magic in there as well. So for instance, if you're retrieving JSON values in an Android application or iOS application, you do not need to parse the whole JSON. It will come back to you either as a instance of a custom class or as a map or dictionary that is already parsed, and you can just start working with it in your application. Once going back to the querying language, there is a bunch of different functions that we added that give you an ability to retrieve data if your JSON documents contain certain value or contain certain path. As far as support for arrays, there are a bunch of different functions to manipulate arrays in stored JSON values. It is super rich. What makes me particularly excited about the whole support for JSON is because it really is a whole new dimension to the kind of data that you can store. Previously, it was fairly simple, you know, key value pairs where you have the key would be a column and it contains a specific value. But now for a specific column of type JSON, it may contain complex JSON value. It could be a JSON object that contains arrays, and those arrays could contain other objects and so on. And all of it is can be consumed individually as individual key values within the JSON documents. Super, super powerful stuff. I'm going to jump into a quick demo to demonstrate how it works. You'll see that it's very rich, and the kind of things that you can do with it will make your application way more powerful than before if you have a use case for unstructured data. Because once again, JSON, the power of JSON stored in a database gives you an ability to store unstructured data. When it comes to structured data, just whatever we had before would work beautifully, especially with support for relations and many other things that Backendless database has. So as I said, let me just jump right into a demo and demonstrate how support for JSON works in Backendless. Now I am in Backendless console, and let's start from the very beginning, which is creating a column of type JSON. I have a table here called person, switch to schema. I already actually have a column of type JSON, which is profile, but if you need to do it, and I'm sure you will be doing that, when you go to schema, click new, and in type, all you need to do is select JSON, give it the name of the column, and that creates the column of type JSON. As simple as that. By the way, columns of type JSON need to be created in console, because whenever you save values and rely on dynamic schema definition, Backendless cannot tell whether you want to store a string or a JSON, so it becomes a little bit ambiguous. And here, from that perspective, and because of that, you need to create them manually using Backendless console. Anyway, so here I have column of type JSON, which is profile, and if I switch to data browser, I have a couple of objects here, and as you can see, in the profile column, I do have JSON values. So if you click on this icon right here, it opens up the JSON editor, and then in here, you can just provide your JSON, save it, modify it, do everything you need to as far as editing of this value. By the way, the same thing applies for the APIs, of course. So once you have a column of type JSON, you can start saving and updating values in that column using your client application and the APIs that we provide.
In here, you can also edit just inline, just click on the cell and start editing, or as I just showed to you, you can open JSON editor. Let's talk about data retrieval. For this, I will switch to REST console and just click GET, which is the most basic request. And as you can see from the structure of the response, I do have a column profile, and the mapped value is going to be JSON. So this is the REST response. And from the REST perspective, it just looks like, you know, the rest of the data that you may have in that table. From the API perspective for native SDKs, such as Android, iOS, .NET, and so on, you will be getting value that is already parsed and presented to you either in the form of a dictionary or a map or a custom class that the value will be mapped down to. So what kind of things can be done from the data retrieval perspective? And everything that I will show to you applies equally to both REST API and the APIs in our native SDKs. So for instance, as you can see here, I have two objects that are coming back. Here they are, these two objects. One of them is a profile for a person called Bob. And the other one, let me expand it right here, is going to be for a person named Joe. So for instance, we want to retrieve the objects where the age property in that JSON. So this is going to be the JSON value that is in the profile. Let's retrieve all the objects where the age, let's say, is greater than 30. So first thing that you will need to learn is how to reference the actual JSON paths in the where clause. And for this, the syntax goes like this. So you put the name of the column, you put this dash and an arrow, and then there is a concept of JSON path. It is the documented in our documentation, but the syntax for that goes like this. So you put it in single quotes, and inside you identify the root of the JSON document with a dollar sign, and then use the dot notation. You can reference the actual properties. So for instance, h, this is going to be the JSON path for h, so dollar sign dot h, and that identifies this age property in the JSON document. So if we want to find all the objects where age is greater than 30, you just put the condition greater than 30, click get, and then you get all the objects. So since both objects satisfy this condition, age here is 55 and age here is 34, then you get both objects. So if we say greater than 35, then we're going to be getting back only one object. And using this notation, you can identify any particular path within the JSON document. So if you want to say where the age is greater than 35 and the state is California, and notice that the state is inside of address. So here you will say and profile dollar sign address state equals California. Click get, and then you get this object. Same goes for arrays. For instance, you want to have find all the users that have a favorite color, such as blue. Now for this, there is a function that we added, and there are several functions, but one of the functions gives you an ability to do matching of the values inside of the JSON document. And that function is JSON contains, and you put here the path to the actual element, and this is going to be profile favorite colors. And then the second argument is going to be the actual value that you want to find. Now the value needs to be JSON on its own, so which means that it must be surrounded in single quotes. And then the JSON for a string is going to be string in double quotes. So for instance, blue, and that needs to be equals one. So the way JSON contains works is the first parameter, the first argument, is going to be JSON path, and the second one is the JSON that you want to match it against. So click get, see, and it finds both objects because blue is actually in both. So here we have blue in favorite colors, and then we have blue in favorite colors for Joe. But if you, let's say if you want to combine it and say age must be greater than 35, click click get, then you get only one object because only one satisfies this criteria. This is quite powerful. And then in here, in the examples that I provided, I'm referencing properties inside of the JSON. But this object right here, in addition to profile, may have other properties that you define, other columns. And you can mix and match conditions for the JSON values with the columns, with other columns defined in your data table. Now, here are some other things that you can do. So here we were playing with the where clause. But for instance, you have a JSON document and you want to retrieve a value from that JSON document as an individual property in the response. So for instance, we want to get name from all the JSON documents. So in the properties, you will do something like this. You will say profile dollar name as name. So this defines an additional dynamic property. So if you click get, notice that in the response that we get, you get the name property, and there is no column name. This is really a dynamic property that comes from the JSON that comes back as if it is a column in your data table. And this can go on. You can just define as many properties as you want. This approach is available in all SDKs as well as the REST API, as you can see right here. You can actually store not only JSON documents, as we do right here, but your JSON columns can contain arrays. So another example that I have here, a table called lottery. And in here, you see there is a results. Let me just show you. There is a results column of type JSON. And the results column contains just arrays. So these are the results, let's say, of some imaginable lottery. So these are the winning numbers. And in here, you can just start working with these arrays as well. So you, let's say you want to find all the lottery results that contain a specific number. So in here, we go to REST console and type in JSON contains. And the column name that contains JSON is called results. And then the second argument needs to be valid JSON, so we put it in single quotes, and it's going to be number 10 and equals 1. Click get. Well, there is no number 10. How about number 8? There you go. So these are the results that contain number 8. What if you want to match multiple numbers? So for instance, 8 and 12. Well, in here, then we convert the second argument to an array, and we put 8 and 12 in there. Click get, and now we get the results that contain both numbers. What if you want to do the OR operation? Like, for instance, contains 8 or 12. Well, in this case, you can do it like this. Equals 1, or put another one for 12. Click get, and in this case, you get all the results that contain either 8 or 12. As you can see, there are two results for this. So as you can see, it is quite powerful. And in our documentation, we document all the new functions that we have added into the where clause. And this is quite big. And I cannot imagine the kind of things that you will be building with it, but it does open up a lot of possibilities for storing and manipulating data, especially unstructured data, for your applications. I hope you are as excited about it as I am, because I know that this really creates a lot of really, really cool possibilities. Thank you for watching this video, guys, and as always, happy coding.